Hello and welcome to Shadakup. Our today's recipe is Chinese dosa. It is getting very popular nowadays and it is basically a Chinese twist to your Indian dosa. It tastes really, really good. It forms a bulk of noodles and vegetables. So let us start. So we're going to start with the filling. We have took about half cup of capsicum. To that we're going to add half cup of cabbage. And you can see we have cut all the vegetables in julienne, and next we are adding onion. Here we have took about half cup of onion, half cup of carrot. We have took all vegetables of half cup, and lastly we are adding noodles. We have took Hakka noodles and we have boiled them, and we have added just a pinch of turmeric for color, but it's optional. Okay, so next we are adding about 1.5 teaspoon of Schezwan sauce. It is very easily available in the market, or we also have a video on how to make Schezwan sauce at home. You can check it on our channel Shada Cook, or I will also link it down in the description box. 1 teaspoon of red chili sauce, 1/2 teaspoon of soya sauce, and 1/4 teaspoon of salt, because all sauce also has the salt. And now we are going to mix everything well. So filling is ready. And here we have took dosa batter. Okay, so over here we have took a dosa tawa. So we are gonna start by heating our tawa. It should be very hot. So once it gets very hot, we are going to lower the flame. And then we are going to sprinkle water and wipe it with tissue or a cloth. This way, a normal temperature of the tawa is maintained. Okay, so we are gonna start by spreading our dosa batter. Make sure to keep your batter a little thicker, because we are going to put the vegetables on the top and we want our vegetables to be cooked properly. To that we are going to add butter and just spread the butter all over so that your batter gets cooked properly, and it also gives a very nice crispiness and a nice flavor. Okay, so we are moving our spatula just in this way so that the batter gets even and our butter spreads properly all over. So next we are going to be putting our filling. On the top we are adding about 2 teaspoons of tomato ketchup, but this is optional, but it gives a very nice flavor. You can use it when you're giving it to your kids. And we are adding butter. And now we are going to just mix the sauce and the filling together. And now we are going to cover it and let it cook for about a minute, and make sure you keep it on low flame so that your batter down does not get burned. Okay, so it's been a minute and it's all butter on the top, and now we are just spreading the vegetables all over. So we have spreaded it all over, and you can see our dosa batter has got nice and brown on the corners. So now we are just going to fold the dosa. And you can see it came out with such a precision and it has got a very nice brown color. So there we go, our Chinese dosa is ready, and you can see the vegetables in. They're nice and juicy and crunchy and really tasty. And our dosa on the top is also nice and crispy. It has a very nice Chinese taste. So do try it. It's very simple to make. And let us know how does it comes out. If you like this video, do thumbs up and subscribe. Thank you so much for watching. Bye-bye. Hello everyone, welcome to our channel Shada Cook. Our today's recipe is Chinese Bhel. This is an Indo-Chinese recipe, so let's see what we need for this recipe. 1 bowl of fried noodles. We have took Hakka noodles. All you need to do is soak these Hakka noodles for 15 minutes in cold water. Then drain them off and keep it for 1 hour.
Then just fry them. Next we need 1/2 cup of lengthwise cut capsicum, 1/2 cup of shredded carrots, 1/2 cup of shredded cabbage, 1/2 cup of lengthwise cut spring onion, some spring onion leaves, 2 teaspoons of Schezwan sauce. And if you need recipe for this, we have the recipe for Schezwan sauce on our channel Sharda Cook, or I will also link it down below in the description box. 3 teaspoons of tomato ketchup, salt to taste, 1 teaspoon of soya sauce and some oil. Heat the pan, add oil. Heat the oil. Now we are going to add capsicum. Next we are going to add cabbage, spring onion. We are going to just lightly saute them, shredded carrots. Now we are going to add salt. Next we are adding Schezwan sauce, tomato ketchup. Mix everything well. Now we are going to add soya sauce. Now those fried haka noodles and toss everything well. Now on the top, lastly we are going to add some spring onion leaves. Mix everything well. It's ready, turn off the flame. So a Chinese bhel is ready to be served and enjoy. It's a very simple recipe. Make sure to subscribe and thumbs up this video if you liked it. Thank you so much for watching. Bye bye. Hello everyone, welcome to Cooking with Sharda. Our today's recipe is Schezwan sauce. It is an Indo-Chinese recipe. It is used to make Schezwan rice, Schezwan noodles, etc. It can be also used as dips. We have also uploaded a Schezwan rice video, so you can definitely check that out on our Sharda Cook channel. I will also link it in the description box down below. So now let's see what we need to make the Schezwan sauce. 4 teaspoons of red chili paste. We also have the video on how to make red chili paste. You can check it on Sharda Cook channel. I will also link it down below in the description box. 3 teaspoons of finely chopped garlic. 1 teaspoon of finely chopped ginger. Salt to taste. 1/2 teaspoon of black pepper. 1/2 teaspoon of powdered sugar. 2 teaspoons of chili sauce. 1/2 teaspoon of soya sauce. 1 teaspoon of vinegar. It's not visible in video, but 4 teaspoons of oil. Now we'll start preparing for that. Heat the pan. Now we will add in oil. Heat the oil. Now add garlic. Next is ginger. We are going to saute them lightly. Saute them until they get light brown. Now you can see it has got light brown color. Now it's time to add red chili paste. Mix everything well. Cook it on a low flame. Next we will add salt, black pepper, give it a mix. Next is chili sauce, then soya sauce. Now we are going to add just a little bit of water. Now we will add sugar. And lastly vinegar. Mix everything well. And your sauce is ready. Turn off the flame. So our Schezwan sauce is ready, you can see. And it tastes really nice, like tangy and sweet, and it goes great for some Indo-Chinese recipes like the rice and noodles. So do try it, it's very easy. If you like this video, thumbs up. Thank you so much for watching. Bye bye. Hello everyone, welcome to Sharda Cook. Our today's recipe is hot and sour soup. So let's go through the ingredients. For this we need 1/4 cup of finely chopped carrot, 1/4 cup of finely chopped cabbage, 1/4 cup of finely chopped cauliflower, 1/4 cup finely chopped capsicum, 1/4 cup of finely chopped spring onion whites and green, 1 teaspoon of finely chopped garlic, finely chopped green chili, 3 teaspoons of soya sauce, 1 teaspoon of red chili sauce, 1 teaspoon of vinegar. If you want, you can also use lemon as a substitute to vinegar. 3 teaspoons of corn flour, 2 teaspoons of oil, salt to taste, black pepper, 1/2 teaspoon sugar, and 3 to 4 cups of vegetable stock. And it's very easy to make a vegetable stock. All you need to do is boil some water, add in some vegetables and let it boil for about 3 to 4 minutes. Then strain it and you get the vegetable stock. If you want, you can also use water as a substitute to the vegetable stock. So let's start the preparation. For that, heat the pan, add oil. Next, add garlic. Then we're gonna add green chili. Next, we're gonna start adding our vegetables, that is carrot. Make sure to keep it on high flame. Next, we're gonna add cabbage, capsicum, cauliflower, spring onion, white and green. Now let your vegetables cook for about 2 minutes. Make sure to stir it continuously, otherwise it will get stick to the pan and it will get burned. So keep on stirring it for 2 minutes. So it's been 2 minutes and vegetables are cooked. So now we are going to add vegetable stock. If you want, you can also add water. Now we'll add the sauces. First, we're adding soya sauce, red chili sauce, and vinegar. Mix it well. Now let's add the seasoning. For that, first we are adding salt, pepper, and some sugar. And now mix it well. Okay, so now we are going to take the corn flour. In that, slowly add some water and then mix it well. Make a nice paste. The reason to mix it in the water before, so that you don't have lumps in your soup, and make sure that you use a cold water. So now lastly, we are going to add a corn flour paste, and now keep on stirring it continuously for about 2 minutes. And if you feel like it's a little bit thick, you can add more water. So just keep on stirring it until you get the boils. So it has got the boils, so our soup is ready. Turn off the flame. So our hot and sour soup is ready. It tastes both spicy and sour. It is an amazing Chinese recipe. This is the vegetarian version and it is just perfect for this winter season. If you like this video, do thumbs up and subscribe. Thank you so much for watching. Bye bye.